Hello, welcome to the channel Autumn's Booktique. I am Autumn, and this is going to be my January through April wrap-up. So, from January through April, I read a total of 22 books, so this video is going to be kind of on the longer side, so I'm going to keep my, like, thoughts and, like, reviews on the books, like, kind of small, and I am going to be trying to post like actual reviews on my Goodreads. So if you want to check out like more of my thoughts, then you can go ahead and go check that. I will be probably linking all of the books in the description box. So if you want to know what the books are about, you can go ahead and click that and find out. Let's just dive right in. So in January, I read a total of 7 books, and the first 4 books were a part of my Getting Back Into Reading vlog, which I will link in the iCard if you want to check it out. The first book being Front Desk by Kelly Yang. I gave it a 5 out of 5 stars. Absolutely adored it. Such a cute and important middle grade. Absolutely stunning. Highly recommend it. And then the second book is the sequel to that, 3 Keys by Kelly Yang. Another 5-star read. It was stunning. Just an excellent middle grade character to follow. So I highly recommend it if you like the middle grade genre. It was adorable. And I think the third book is coming out in September. I think so. It's kind of coming up soon. So yeah. The third book I read was Nothing to See Here by Kevin Wilson. I gave it a 4 out of 5 stars. It was such a funny read. Such a good time and just such a funny read for me. So for the last book for that vlog and the 4th book of the month was Wicked and the Wallflower by Sarah McLean. I gave it a 3 out of 5 stars. I really enjoyed it. It was a good romance. I just felt like it was a little too long and it was just very repetitive. But other than that, it was a really good read and it was just genuinely a fun read. And then I read House in the Cerulean Sea by TJ Klun. Gave it a 5 out of 5 stars, and it's probably my favorite book I've read so far this year. Absolutely phenomenal. So many feels after reading this book. It was absolutely exquisite. Then I read Not the Girl You Marry by Andy J. Christopher. I gave it a 3 out of 5 stars. It was fine. It was just kind of meh, you know, not much happened, but it was still like kind of enjoyable. Then I read Don't You Forget About Me by Mahari McFarlane and gave it 3 out of 5 stars as well. Once again, another meh romance. It was just kind of okay. I have a soft spot for romances that take place in bars, and this does that. So yeah, if it didn't take place in a bar, it probably would have been a 2-star, maybe. I don't know. But yeah. So I did not end up reading a single book in February. So in March, I started with Stargazing by Jen Yang. Such an amazing graphic novel. It's just so sweet and just so good. I even like started crying at one point. Jen Yang just knows how to make graphic novels. Just absolutely amazing. I really, really recommend it. It was so good. Then I read Shadow and Bone by Leigh Bardugo and gave it a 3 out of 5 stars. It was decent. It was good. I didn't really like any of the characters. I know. I'm sorry. And then the last book I read in March was The Roommate by Rosie Dannon. I gave it a 3 out of 5 stars. It was just an okay romance. Nothing about it like blew me away. Nothing about it like kept me gripped throughout the entire time. I kind of had trouble finishing it. So then in April, I read a total of 12 books, starting with Siege and Storm by Leigh Bardugo. I gave this 3 out of 5 stars. Once again, just, it wasn't what I was expecting. Like, I was expecting to be head over heels in love with it, and it just wasn't to that standard. I did really enjoy the character that was added into this book. He is probably my favorite character to exist so far in this series. Then during my weekly vlog from April 5th to April 11th, I read Act Your Age, Eve Brown by Talia Hibbert and gave it a 4 out of 5 stars. Just, I love Talia Hibbert's romances. They're absolutely amazing. This just, after Danny Brown, this one kind of disappointed me a tiny bit, just because Dani Brown is my favorite of the Brown Sisters trilogy, and it was just so good. So I was a little disappointed that this one wasn't better than Dani Brown. But I still really enjoyed it, though. I still really recommend it to all romance lovers. It was excellent. Then I read When No One Was Watching by Alyssa Cole, and I gave it a 5 out of 5 stars. Sorry. Absolutely stunning. I loved it. I was really struggling with thriller for a while, and this, like, just put me back to that place of wanting to just constantly pick up thrillers. So, excellent, excellent read. Then I read Across the Green Grass Fields by Seanan McGuire, 4 out of 5 stars. Absolutely adored this. I love this series so, so, so much. This one did give me some, like, secondhand anxiety just because I am afraid of horses, so that wasn't exactly fun, but it was still a really, really good book, and I loved following Reagan. It was really good time. And then the last book that was featured in that vlog was Dragon Pearl by Yoon-Ha Lee. I gave it a 4 out of 5 stars. Absolutely loved this. Such a good middle grade. The only thing is, I actually ended up enjoying the plot, or the world building and the character development, more than the actual plot. So, I mean, the plot was good, don't get me wrong, but I loved, loved, loved finding the world and, like, figuring out this world. It was so, so enjoyable. So that's the only reason I docked it 1 star. The 6th book I read in April is Lost in the Neverwoods by Aidan Thomas. I give this a 5 out of 5 stars. This is also probably a favorite of the year. I absolutely adored this. It was everything I wanted it to be. It's a Peter Pan retelling, and it was just so, so, so good. So well done. I absolutely loved it. And then the next 5 books were a part of my episode 2 of Tackling My TBR and little 24-hour readathon vlog, which I will link up there or in the description. I don't know. Wherever I'll be linking it, it will be clickable. And the first book I read for that was From the Desk of Zoe Washington. Gave it a 5 out of 5 stars. Absolutely stunning middle grade. It was so, so, so amazing. I loved every aspect of it, and it was just so sweet, so beyond sweet, and I loved it so much. Then I read Fangs by Sarah Anderson. I gave it a 5 out of 5 stars. Another just so such a cute graphic novel. It was so, so good. It's about a vampire and a werewolf getting together. And if that doesn't reel you in, I don't know what else I can say about it to make you want to read this book, because it was just so good. It was so good, and I loved it. Then I read The Midnight Library by Matt Haig, and I gave it a 3 out of 5 stars. Unfortunately, this one just isn't for me. I thought it had a very different premise than it does, and so I was a little let down because I was expecting that to happen rather than what actually happened. And so I couldn't focus on what was actually happening because I was just so sad that it wasn't what I wanted to happen, you know? Yeah. But it was good. It was still an enjoyable time, but yeah. Then I read With the Fire on High by Elizabeth Acevedo, gave it a 5 out of 5 stars. Once again, an amazing, amazing book. It was so, so, so good. It's so many like different factors to this that just made it so amazing. And it was such a good book, such a good book. Then the last book I read for the 24-hour readathon was The OK Witch by Emma Steinkellner. I gave this a 4 out of 5 stars. It was really, really cute and enjoyable, but just something, there just was something missing about it that just didn't push me over to the 5-star edge, if that makes sense. But it was still really, really cute and just really enjoyable. And like, the art style is absolutely stunning. Then the last book I read was Horimiya Volume 1. I gave it a 4 out of 5 stars, and it was such a cute manga. So cute, and I cannot wait to continue with this series because I know I'm gonna love it all. I know I am. So yeah, that is all of the books I've read in 2021 so far. It has been an amazing reading year for me so far, and I want to hold on to that as long as possible because I feel like I'm just now starting to figure out, like, what books I will like. So there's not as many like disappointments, and I'm loving that for myself. It is so enjoyable. It is so fun being able to read book after book of books you like, and it's just, it's such a rewarding feeling. I love it. I love it. It feels like great getting to read books you like, you know? I do want to mention though, I have been like sort of changing my review style, how I'm like what 1 through 5 stars mean. And I do think once I like set that in stone, I will be making a video about it, just like a little like how I review books type of video, you know, just to kind of key you guys in on what goes through my mind and how I decide to rate books. So yeah, if you are curious about that, keep your eyes peeled. It's probably gonna happen within the next month or so. Thank you so much for watching. I really hope you liked it. And if you did, I would really appreciate it if you liked and subscribed. And I will see you in another video very soon. All right, bye.